Shabbat Shalom. The Gemara in Masachet Megillah, Daf Lamed Beit, tells us that the kololot, the very dire warning of punishment that will befall us if we sin, that are found in Devarim, are said before Rosh Hashanah. But in the Tosfot record a question that was asked in the yeshiva of Rav Nissen Gaon. It's a very simple question. In our custom, the klolot, the tochechat, as in Parsha Kitavo, is always read 2 weeks before Rosh Hashanah. But in the Shabbos, right before Rosh Hashanah, we read Nitzavim. That's against the Gemara. How can this be? And the answer they propose is that, you know, the basic idea is teklesh shanah v'kilolotea. That's the good riddance to the year that's ending and all the troubles it brought us. And let's start a new year full of blessings. But since Parshat Nitzavim also has some dire warnings, some klalot, not as lengthy and as fearsome as those in Kitavo, but still pretty frightening, so you might as well get rid of those before we start the new year. But the Rabbi Soloveitchik has a different idea. Different idea. The reason that we read Nitzavim before Shoshanah and not Kitavo is that in Kitavo, the klalot there, the tochicha, does not mention teshuvah, doesn't mention repentance. Whereas in our parsha, Nitzavim, the one we will read tomorrow, the Torah mentions tshuva. It mentions tshuva several times. It mentions v'shavta ad Hashem Elokecha. It basically promises us that we will eventually do tshuva. And this blessing, almost a miracle, that people can change themselves and make radical shifts in their behavior and in their attitudes and in their ideas and get off the wrong track and get on the right track, is one of the greatest blessings that we have, one of the greatest miracles that God has made for us. And it's in Parshat Nitzavim, and it's something that we should have in mind before we celebrate Rosh Hashanah Yom Adin, which is not a day of feasting and jubilation. It's a day of Emat Adin, it's a day of being really feeling like we're standing in court and fighting for our lives. But the Parsha mentions tshuva actually twice. It mentions our tshuva, that we will return to God, v'shavta ad Hashem Elokecha, but it also mentions kaviyachol God's tshuva, v'shav Hashem Elokecha et shivutcha. And here there's a very simple grammatical issue which the Rashi raises. If this means that God is going to return us, bring us back to our homeland, the geula that we like to believe we're seeing the beginnings of now, then it should be the transitive form, the heshiv Hashem et shivutcha. Veshav means to come back, means that God himself will come back. And this brings Rashi already to raise the issue, or raise the idea which became so important in later Jewish thought, particularly in the Kabbalah, of galut ha-shekhina, that the shekhina, God's divine presence, this sort of projection that we can't understand, the projection of the divinity onto this world, is also in galus, is following us around through our tribulations from country to country and persecution to persecution. And when the gula comes, when the redemption comes, the shekhina will also return. And this is mentioned by the Rav. And the Rav has a very interesting and important point, that what is the purpose of Golut Shechina? The purpose is that, you know, our behavior is, you know, kacha kacha. We're sometimes very good, sometimes not so good, and we can't always be sure that we really deserve the redemption, the gula that we pray for and long for and expect. So God has put in collateral, divine collateral. He has placed his Shechina with us, so he has to redeem us, because he has to redeem his own Shechina. His own Shechina is with us as sort of on loan, as a collateral to secure and to guarantee our redemption. And this is another divine promise, that because the Shechina is in galut, and God has to redeem the shekhina. He can't let the shekhina be in exile and wandering constantly away from its home. Then the shekhina will be redeemed and will come along for the ride, so to speak. So this is a very encouraging message in our parsha. And since in today's issue of Haaretz, our own Israeli anti-Semitic rag, which seems to compete with the New York Times, we can be more, spew out more hatred for the Jews. In today's issue of Haaretz, they wrote that the number one priority of the government that may or may not be forming, as I speak now, no one really knows what's going on. The number one priority is to get rid of the Mashiachistim, a new political slur that was very prominent in the last election campaign. Everyone who doesn't seem to think the way Harris is a messianic fanatic and someone who's lost his mind. And so with that in mind, let me say end with this, again, this idea that the redemption will come because the Shekhinah is with collateral, and I will wish that Mashiach Zekeinu will come as soon as possible. The Mashiach is waiting for us. It's not that we're waiting for him, waiting for us to be worthy of coming, but in view of the propaganda and the insightful speech and talk in the last elections, let me say that I wish the Mashiach will come. So here's the messianic ending to this video. And come and get me, Haaretz. Shabbat Shalom and Shana Tovah.